it's the True Review here. So this is it. My personal top 10 worst games ever. This is quite the dedication to gaming. You're about to witness some of the worst video games ever to be released. If you've had the unfortunate pleasure of coming across any of these games, then I feel for you, and you know exactly what I mean when I mention them. Ready? Okay, let's do this. Daikatana! As much as I really don't like this game, it always makes me sad when I think about it. This game could have been the nuts, but instead it turned out to be balls. Wait, balls are nuts. Okay, bad analogy. This game could have been sick, but it turned out to be a pile of puke. Shit, done it again. You know what I mean. But Arnstorm knew that they were onto something good when they started making this game. But somewhere along the ridiculously long development stage of the game, it fell massively from grace. The Arnstorm development staff probably had this in mind when they thought up the game. Daikatana! But instead of that, we got this.
Derp. Derpity derp 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 derp.
This game has shit AI, a shit story, out-of-date graphics upon release, the main weapon is shit, one of the worst save systems I've ever seen, puzzles that ask a lot of the player, but I could put that all aside. Who am I kidding, it still pissed me off. But the number one issue I have with this game is the amount of bugs it has. It's unplayable, and I'm not kidding here. There's this one part that I can't get past because the game keeps crashing every time I get to it, so I've never been able to finish the game. But f*** it, I say, that's probably a good thing anyway. Despite all of this, there are a couple of elements to like about the game. The idea behind the story is gripping, and the variety of weapons is satisfying, and some of them are fun to try out. Not a 100% fail of a game, but enough to make it to number 10 on the worst games list. Working 9 to 5, what a way to make a living. Dead or Alive Extreme! And dropping the E makes it even more extreme. How is this game extreme? Extremely shit, more like. I can sum up what's happened with this game in one line. Someone on the DOA developing team has gone, "Do you know what? I would really like to own a game I could wank over." No one ever plays DOA Extreme for the gameplay. There's no gameplay in it. Or at least there's no gameplay you can actually enjoy. This game is one big purrfest. You control one of a number of ridiculously big racked babes wearing practically nothing, giving each other gifts and compliments and throwing their junk around whilst trying to play beach volleyball. And it's not like there's even a volleyball competition going on. All of the matches are friendly, so even if you lose, it doesn't count for shit. And if you win, then you can buy even more skimpy swimwear for your girls and gifts for other girls, and that's it. The whole game is basically just a bunch of girls doing everything they can to keep their boobs moving the entire day. You can label this one however you like, but you cannot deny what it really is, and that's an erotic game. It's not a f***ing sports game! Unless you count one girl rubbing sun cream onto another girl's back a sport. And hold on tight, cause it's gonna be wilder than any exciting ride. JFK Reloaded! Oh my god, even the title sounds bad. This game was intended to be a means of looking at the JFK assassination from a historical and possibly a scientific point of view as a way of determining where the assassin actually was during the event, but this game just ended up being one of the most inappropriate games ever made. If the sight of President Kennedy's brain flying all over the car isn't enough to convince you that this game is just horrible, then perhaps another look at the killing from the slow motion death cam will.
Goodman.
Bone Town! Bone Town barely works. This is a game that I played recently, and for fuck's sake, why do people have to make shit like this? It's such a bad game that... No, it's more of an interactive porn mag than anything else. I'll tell you what, take GTA San Andreas. Now, remove all the vehicles, guns, plot, fun, James Woods and co, and replace it all with a sex offender, and that still doesn't begin to describe how bad this is. The point of the game is to get big balls. Why? She can fuck any girl that happens to walk by. What kind of place is this where people just have sex right there in the street? Even at the start of the game, the first girl you see tells you about the town and then you end up fucking her. Where in the world does this happen? Yeah, New Jersey, I know. And check out some of your guys' pickup lines. Let me fuck you like that dead dog I found in the trash. But then there's the combat. Worst ever. Basically, a one-on-one fight is quite hard, but doable. Unless you have a weapon, in which case it's still hard, but you should win the fight quicker. If it's 2-on-1, then you're in for a toughie, and if it's more than that, then forget it. You lose immediately, because all of your enemy's attacks are unrelenting. They don't stop, and you can't fight back while getting attacked, making this game impossible to complete unless you use cheats. And even then, you still might fail the mission, because someone else got beaten up, and you couldn't help them because you were in the middle of your own bruising session. Some areas are impossible to visit or see, because the game either crashes when you enter, or just doesn't load up at all, making some missions impossible to complete. This game is simply unplayable, and I dare you to play it. No, actually, stay the fuck away from this one. That's an order. Catechumen. Ah, we're really getting balls deep into some shit here. Yes, Catechumen. Cat and cumin. It's a Christian first-person shooter. Let me say that again. A Christian first-person shooter. What the f*** to the max? I didn't realise that Christianity and FPS games go together, but apparently Catechumen does. There are a few religious FPS games out there that I'm aware of too, but as far as I know, they're as bad as this, so I'm just going to talk about this one. Catechumen gets you playing in the Roman times as a... well, what else? A catechumen. I don't really know what one of these are, and I'm not really asked to find out what it means. You start off outside some Roman villa or something, and very soon, you come across a floating fairy, who's supposed to be an angel with disproportionate arms, who then gives you a sword that shoots lasers, and orders you to... actually, I don't even know if he orders you to do anything. After this point, you just go around trying to get to the end of the level and occasionally shooting lasers at Romans or demons. But do these lasers kill anything? Well, the demons get destroyed, but there's a religious undertone there. But the Romans don't die from it, oh no. They become so awed by your shooting that they are forced to their knees and start praying. What a load of crap! The level design's crap. There's no real objective but to get to the end of the level for some reason. The graphics are an abortion. There's no music, just sound effects, which aren't even convincing. The puzzles are way, way too easy to figure out, and it's not in the slightest bit challenging to the player. But most importantly of all, this is a Christian FPS. What, did you think that it was going to be good?
And my wife is dead.
Oh, and the game is bugged. Massively bugged.
And my wife is dead.
I'm sorry to hear that.
High five!
Extreme Paint Brawl. You know what, just go ahead and put all of the paintball games down in this one. They're all as bad as each other. Each one is broken, and although each one shows off better graphics than the last, the graphics are still terrible compared to what was available at the time of their release. Countless bugs haunt these games. The paintball guns are never accurate, the music is really misplaced, and I really can't get over the fact that the other players stop shooting, put their hands up and say, "out," when they get shot. Imagine that happening in Quake 3 Arena or Unreal Tournament. You blast your enemy to the point where there's only just their hand left, and all of a sudden, the hand just props up on its own and goes, "I'm out." The 10-second respawn timer is a real kicker as well. It makes sense in multiplayer games, so that the level isn't flooded with players continuously respawning where they left off and making it difficult for any team to win, but this is offline. Who cares? Is this supposed to be humane for the bots? Yeah, this one's bad. E.T. for the Atari 2600. It was hyped before release. It wasn't tested before release. It was hated after release. It was returned in thousands upon release. Most copies ended up being buried in New Mexico after release. It effectively dissolved Atari soon after release. It effectively caused the video game crash of 1983 soon after release. This is the E.T. story in a nutshell. We've all heard it. But there's a reason for why all this happens, and yes, there are many bad games out there. But just take a second to step back and look at how much damage this game did. This one game threw the video game industry into a crisis, and partially resulted in a global economic depression, despite that depression only being slight. I mean, come on, the world economy isn't purely based on video games now, is it? But it was enough to knock a dent in it. The game was as basic games come. People were expecting a really badass game that was going to follow the film closely, but instead, the public got a blob being chased by what looks like a pedo, who occasionally falls into holes and then you can't get out again. This was worse than the response when Pac-Man for Atari was released, but this game was effectively the start of a trend that can still be seen today, and that is, video game adaptations of movies are almost always going to be dread, and E.T. for Atari is a classic example of that. Superman 64. Did Titus Software even try playing this one? In fact, this company wasn't doing too bad until they released this title, and then it all went downhill. Superman on the N64 was the reason why stress balls were invented. You think Ninja Gaiden is hard? Well, at least you can get some enjoyment out of that one. How about playing a game where you have to fly through hoops with no f-ups, and then go to the next part of the level, and be expected to know exactly what to do straight away, and with like 15 seconds to do it in? Oh, and if you mess up at any point in this part, you go back to the hoops again. Already done the f***ing hoops, why must I do them again? I can't believe that anyone in their right minds would think that this game is okay to launch. I guess the testing staff were out for lunch when this game came out. With terrible graphics, gameplay from hell, and so much more, Superman 64 has rightly been dubbed many times as one of the worst games ever released. Big Rigs Over the Road Racing. If you're a connoisseur of bad games, then chances are you've heard about this one, or, God forbid, you own it. Big Rigs has widely been recognised as the worst game ever created for one reason. It's so bad because it just doesn't work. Nothing works! You can enter the game okay, that's not the problem. Hell, you can even select a track and a truck to race with. Then the race loads up and you're thinking, hey, this looks okay. Graphics aren't too good and the music is wank, but I could get used to it. But then the race starts. First of all, you'll notice that your opponent isn't moving. Well, that's the race over with then, I guess I won. But it gets worse. There's also no proper texture or clipping in the game. Although there's scenery like townhouses and bridges, they might as well be invisible because you can drive straight through them. Go ahead, aim for a building. You'll go through it like it's a ghost or something. Going over bridges is even funnier. Your truck just disappears. Hey, what the f*** happened to- Oh, it was underneath. Your truck is anchored to the ground and will not come off of it for love nor money. And you'll never lose momentum either, even when reversing. Go ahead, reverse all you want, you'll end up reversing at 140 miles an hour. Also, when was the last time you saw someone drive straight up a vertical mountain like it was a piece of flat road? Oh, what now? What's it doing? I think it's doing the safety dance. Finally, if you thought that all of that was bad enough, then check out what happens when you finish a race. And obviously win. This comes up. What? You're winner. They got your wrong. It says you are winner. Wow, I are wiener. Congratulations. Piece of shit. One more time. Replay. The Japanese erotic gaming company called Illusion published the game back in 2006, and ever since I played it, I haven't been able to look at bad games in the same way ever again. Before, when I played bad games, I was all like, f*** me, this is shit. But now I'm like, well, at least it's not rape play. You play as a messed up Japanese teen who really, really likes rape. After being tried as a perv because you got caught by some random big-breasted girl, you're released by your rich dad, and then you go after the girl who caught you in order to exact revenge. You start by getting at her family to begin with, first by raping the girl's younger sister, then her mum, and then finally the girl you've been after. Once this is done, the main character decides to keep them all in captivity as sex slaves. The rest of the game is just you constantly f***ing each one until they are mentally cracked and just accept what's happening. Then, you just replay the rape. And yes, that's why this is called replay. Now, I can't stand this game for more than 30 seconds, and I've never even tried to complete this game, but apparently, there are two endings. One is where you commit suicide because you got one of the girls pregnant, and then the other one is where one of the girls kills you whilst you're raping her. That's the story, now let's look at some of the other aspects of the game. The controls. The controls have to be, hands down, the worst I've ever seen, and I'm not just saying that because I f***ing hate this game. The controls are awkward and don't make sense. The sounds and music are terrible and do really well at reflecting what kind of game you're playing, that being a terrible one. And the English subtitle translations were done by someone who can't speak English. Rayplay is one of the worst games out there, and don't let anyone else tell you otherwise. Now, I realise that I'm actually taking a risk here by talking about this game, because some of you will now be curious to go out and play it. Please, please don't. I'm being serious here. This game is sick, and not in an enjoyable way, like a guilty pleasure or something. And I feel genuinely upset each time I have to talk about it. I've installed this game twice now, the first time to see what it was like, and the second time to record the footage for this video, and I've only recorded the slightly tasteful parts. There's a lot I'm leaving out here for both legal and moral reasons, so please, don't go there with this one. And there you have it, the top 10 worst games out there. Well, that's not entirely true. I might do a part 2 to this in the same way as I did with the scariest games, and to be frank, I've already got a few in mind. So keep me posted into the ones in which you would like to see in the next Worst Games list. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and to check out all of the previous True Review episodes, either on YouTube or at the True Review website, and I'll see all of you beautiful, beautiful people very soon.